We are living in a universe where particles are interacting every single time. See this book I got here? The electrons in my hands are actually repelling the electrons of the book.
Really?
If that doesn't convince you, we can make a cloud chamber from dry ice and see these amazing patterns of particles interacting with other particles.
You ask what's behind all that? Quantum field theory.
Okay, let's start with the word quantum. Quantum can be closely associated with probability, like rolling a dice.
Now if this dice is interaction, for example, when electrons repel, and we throw these dice in an electron-electron field, the quantum field theory will tell us what happens when the fields interact with a certain probability.
Doesn't mean there are a lot of possibilities as to how electrons repel, not just repel because of their negative charges? Yes and no. Electrons repel not just due to their charges. That's a classical view. In a quantum view, they repel because of exchanging virtual photons.
What? Let's use Feynman diagrams to visualize that. When electrons happen to be near each other, a virtual photon is emitted by one electron and the other electron absorbs it, hence the repulsion.
Easy as it sounds, right? Well, remember, I did emphasize other possibilities going on when electrons repel. That means, aside from this diagram, there are other diagrams too.
No!
To solve that, we need to find which diagram among others is most probable so we can approximate. A theory called perturbation will help us find that. And let's use this paper as an analogy.
Suppose that I put a value of this whole paper as 1. Folding it once becomes 1 half, twice becomes 1/4, and so on. But as we go on to fold it many times, the number contributes less to the value of the whole paper. So, 1 half becomes the best approximate to 1.
Like folds in the paper, diagrams have vertices, the area where electrons absorb or emit photons.
How many vertices a diagram has is also how much is its probability to happen. Specifically, one vertex contributes approximately 1 over 137. That's the Fine structure constant. Two vertices contribute to the constant squared, and the others follow the same pattern. But since there are no one vertex diagrams, we can now approximate the two vertex diagram as the most probable interaction when electrons repel.
But wait, there's an exception to using perturbation. Diagrams called loops actually add up to contribute a bigger probability, meaning we need to include them in our approximation. But when scientists did that, it led to an infinity. This required them to use a mathematical technique called renormalization. It's very complicated, but the idea is that we get rid of the infinities by introducing a cutoff, so we can have finite values.
Now the importance of these values goes back to this book, The Cloud Chamber, and exceptionally, the whole universe.
They describe how quantum fields function in the microscopic world, and the only thing we see in our daily lives, that is in a macroscopic world, are the ones with the highest probability.